Other corporate stories now. The board of Far Eastern University authorizes the company to enter into a shareholders agreement with MGHI Holdings, which is a member of the Unilab Group. The deal states both FEU and MGHI will invest up to 300 million pesos each in Higher Academia Incorporated, which will then buy the assets of Colegio de Sebastian in Pampanga, a secondary and tertiary school in the central Philippine province. Meanwhile, premium real estate developer Shang Properties setting its sights on Cebu province for two new projects next year. The luxury property developer made this announcement during its logo rebranding Wednesday. Should the plan push through, this will be the first time it will be bringing its brand outside Metro Manila. The company is also bullish on an increase in sales despite some economic challenges.
We're optimistic. Housing is a real need, and we know that people really invest into the places they live in.
Actually, looking at Cebu,
and we actually went there just to introduce our Manila projects last month. And there's something really exciting happening in Cebu next year.
Moving on, a Swedish furniture and homeware retailer IKEA sees robust growth here in the Philippines. That story and more from Denise Dinsai. Denise.
Thanks, Stanley. IKEA Philippines total sales hit 8.7 billion pesos based on its latest financial year report that ended on August 31. Its franchisee and operator, Ikano Retail, says its business saw a double-digit jump in revenue, up 28.3% from last year. IKEA in Pasay City, which is the largest IKEA store in the world, logged 17 million visits during the period. Meanwhile, Ikano Retail, which also operates IKEA stores in Singapore, Malaysia, Thailand, and Mexico, posted a 1.08 billion euro total turnover in its fiscal year.
Former President and now Deputy Speaker Gloria Macapagal Arroyo backing President Marcos's decision on the MIF. Arroyo says Marcos has access to data and must have his reasons for deciding on the suspension. Arroyo is part of the House majority that approved the MIF law last year.
I'm not a member of the economic team. So therefore, as a member of Congress, what I want to say again is to repeat that the president must have his reasons, and we trust his instincts on this. And I think we have nothing to lose if we support the president in the suspension as he deems appropriate.
Several senators also commending the move. Senate Minority Leader Aquilino Pimentel III, who led the filing of a Supreme Court petition against the funds law, says the measure has a lot of defects, and it's no wonder why the law is not ready for implementation. Senators Francis Escudero and Sherwin Gatchalian, meanwhile, say the suspension should be used to correct weaknesses in the law, such as the mandatory capital infusion by government banks.
Sa kasong ito, minandato ng batas na sila'y mag-contribute. Kaya pinaglalaban ko sana na dapat may mandatory minimum profit at guaranteed profit yung mga bankong ito na hindi nakapasa sa period of amendments.
Itong suspension is a prudent move on the part of the president. Dapat natin mapag-aralan mabuti na yung deposito na inilagay ng dalawang banko, DBP and Land Bank, di makaapekto sa stability ng dalawang banko.
Major financial news here at home. The Philippine president puts on hold the implementation of the country's first sovereign wealth fund. An October 12 memo by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. ordered the state treasurer and two government-run lenders to suspend the implementing rules and regulations of his pet measure, which created the Maharlika Investment Fund. The presidential palace says Marcos wants a further study of the IRR to ensure safeguards on the fund. This follows the request by the Development Bank of the Philippines and the Land Bank for regulatory relief from the central bank. The state-owned lenders earlier contributed billions of pesos as seed capital to the MIF. House Ways and Means Panel Chairman Joey Salceda seeks to allay fears over the president's move. The lawmaker economist says the suspension is well within Marcos's powers as president. A University of the Philippines economist, meanwhile, says hitting the brakes on the fund will not look good. to investors.
Investments aren't really coming in, and we're not yet a darling of investors, contrary to what the government is saying. And I think this backtracking when it comes to Maharlika puts a very big cloud of doubt on the ability of the Marcos administration to pursue reforms and improve the business climate of the Philippines.
The ongoing conflict between Israel and Hamas could lead to weaker global output and higher inflation. Now, that warning from the International Monetary Fund during Wednesday's regional economic outlook for Asia and the Pacific. IMF's Krishna Srinivasan says the war could potentially lead to a rise in oil prices and eventually raise the prices of goods.
A 10% increase in oil prices leads to a 0.15% decline in global output the following year, and inflation going up by 0.4 percentage points. Now, clearly, with Laos being an oil importer, the impact is likely to be larger.
Russian President Vladimir Putin praises Chinese leader Xi Jinping for the Belt and Road Initiative. Speaking on his first known trip outside the former Soviet Union since the Ukraine invasion, Putin said Russia can play a key role in China's modern-day revival of the ancient Silk Road. He adds the Belt and Road Initiative fitted with Russia, which he said was developing a host of transport infrastructure to crisscross the world's biggest country, notably from the Northern Sea Route to the Bering Strait near Alaska. The Russian leader also invited global investment in the Northern Sea Route, which he said could deepen trade between the East and the West.